Hi friends, this is Ramya from Vyans Medical Academy. Today, I'll discuss about the semiconductor devices. I'll introduce you why a semiconductor is used in electronic device, and the lecture will flow like this. We'll discuss about the classification of solids, the concept of holes, the forward bias, backward bias, the working of rectifier, transistor, Zener diode, finally the most interesting topic, logic gates. Friends, solids are basically classified into amorphous and crystalline solids. Amorphous solids are those who does not have a sharp melting point, they do not have definite shape also. Coming to crystalline solids, they have sharp melting points, they have definite shape. These crystalline solids are again classified into conductors, insulators and semiconductors. We are all very familiar with these terms, right? What are conductors? Conductors allow the flow of current through them very easily. Insulators does not allow the flow of current through them. Whereas semiconductors partially allow the flow of currents. Partially in the sense they behave as conductors at high temperature and they behave as insulators at low temperature. Friends, we have conductors for passing the electricity, but why are we using these semiconductors? Can anyone answer? Yes, I'll tell you. If we use conductors, the graph will increase like this. If we increase the potential, the current will keep on increasing, which is not necessary for us all the time. In case of semiconductors, the graph will be like this. The current versus potential graph increases like this. You observe it increased linearly, but this didn't. What does that mean? It means that semiconductors allows the flow of current through them in a particular fashion. So, semiconductors are very importantly used as electronic devices. These semiconductors are again classified into intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor, where in intrinsic semiconductors, the number of electrons are equal to the number of holes. So, we call them as pure semiconductors. In case of extrinsic semiconductors, they are again classified into p-type and n-type semiconductors. P-type semiconductor is doped with a low valency impurity, so the number of holes will be greater than the number of electrons. N-type semiconductor is doped with a high valency impurity, so the number of electrons will be greater than the number of holes. This is the end of classification of solids and concept of holes. Let me also tell you about the mass action law. Mass action law tells that n square equals to ne into nh, where n stands for the number of charge carriers before doping, ne stands for the number of electrons after doping, and nh stands for the number of holes per unit volume after doping. Come to the next topic, forward bias and backward bias. Friends, I have already told you about the p-type and the n-type semiconductors, right? In forward bias, the p-type is connected to the positive terminal and the n-type is connected to the negative terminal. In backward bias, it is quite opposite. The p-type is connected to the negative terminal and the n-type is connected to the positive terminal. Here, the graph of forward bias increases like this. And the graph of backward bias will be like this, where you can observe that at certain potential, the circuit gets cut off. That potential is called avalanche potential or Zener potential. This topic is very easy and a question was asked in 2017 NEET, where you can simply read the question and see whether the p-type is connected to positive or negative and tick on the correct option, right? Let's move on to the next topic. Rectifiers. Friends, do you know that the diodes can be used as rectifiers? Yes, it's true. Diodes can be used as rectifiers. The rectifiers are of two types, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. In half wave rectifier, we use only a single diode in which it is forwardly biased. This is the formula for calculating efficiency in case of half wave rectifier, and the maximum efficiency will be around 41.2%. In case of full wave rectifier, we use two diodes in which the first one is forwardly biased and the second one is backwardly biased. This is the efficiency formula and the maximum efficiency will be around 82.4%. Friends, I want to discuss about the input and output in the half wave rectifier. If this is the wave given as input. In case of half wave rectifier, our output will be like this. What did you observe here? Only half of the wave is rectified, so we call it as half wave rectifier. The frequency will be the same in case of input and output. Remember this. In full wave rectifier, if this is the input, again our output will be like this. What did you observe, guys? Here the total wave is rectified, right? So we call it as full wave rectifier, and the frequency is doubled. If input is f, the output will be 2f. Yes, this is regarding the rectifiers. Let's move on to the transistor. In a transistor, the lightly doped base is sandwiched between the heavily doped emitter and intermediately doped collector. Transistors are of two types, PNP transistor and NPN transistor. We can calculate the current amplifications by using these two formulae. We can also calculate the voltage amplification and power amplification very easily. We need to remember the relation between the alpha and beta here, which is very important, where alpha is equal to beta by beta plus 1. Move on to Zener diode. Zener diode, this is the working circuit of Zener diode. Here, if input is passed, it passed through the Zener diode, it all and it comes as output. You need to remember that the output potential always equals to the Zener potential. These four are the important formulae which you need to memorize and practice, by which we can solve the problems very easily. A recently question was asked in 2019 JEE, so work out on this topic, friends. Let's move on to the interesting topic, are logic gates. Why do we call them as logic gates? Because there is some reason or there is some logic behind this, their working, so we call them as logic gates. The equation which is used to express the logic gates is known as the Boolean equation. In logic gate, we use a combination of transistors and diodes. The universal logic gates are OR gate, AND gate and NOT gate. I have given a clear description about these three gates here. Please observe, in case of OR gate, this is the symbol we use, where the output is Y is equal to A or B. Please read it as A or B only, but not A plus B. Friends, I'll tell you a easy trick for doing these OR gates. I said you to not pronounce it as A plus B, but you can do the addition here, right? See, the inputs I gave is 0 and 0. I get the output 0 plus 0 as 0. Inputs are 1, 0. My output will be 1 plus 0 as 1. I gave inputs 0 and 1. My output will be 1. And tell me, what is 1 plus 1? Sure, 99% of you will tell it as 2. But here there is some interesting thing in logic gate, that is, in logic gates we use binary system language, which is used in our calculators and computers. Yeah, can you tell me the working of a calculator? There will be 1 to 9 numbers, right? No, 1 to 9 numbers are not there in a calculator. There is only one number which appears as 8. But actually, this is not 8, these are 7 diodes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See, 7 diodes are present here. When we press the number 0, the middle diode is cut off and it appears as 0 for you. Clear? Tell me, what are the diodes to be cut off to get the number 2? You are right, these two numbers should be cut off to get the number 2. And this is the same logic used in case of logic gates. Now tell me, what is 1 plus 1? Remember that it is binary system and the answer will be 1 only. Yeah, coming to AND gate. Here the symbol of AND gate is easy to remember. In AND gate, D is there, right? And the same D word is the symbol for the AND gate. The output, we should read it as A AND B, not A into B. Already I have told you that you can use the operation A into B and get the answer. See, 0 into 0 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0 and 1 into 1 is 1. Let's see the NOT gate. In NOT gate, only one input is given and we get only one output. But the input is completely inverted in case of NOT gate. So, NOT gates are called inverter gates. See, if the input is 0, my output is 1. If the input is 1, my output here is 0. See that this is the symbol for NOT gate. Read it as Y is equal to A NOT. Okay. Next, by using these three gates, we can obtain many logic gates. Here, I mentioned two other gates. NOR gate, it is a combination of OR and NOT gates, see, where my output will be A OR B NOT. This is the truth table for OR gate. For obtaining the truth table for NOR gate, you need to simply reverse the output, okay? 0 plus 0 is 0, but for our NOR gate, it should be 1. The answer obtained should be reversed and that will be the output. Okay, in coming to the NAND gate, it is a combination of AND gate and NOT gate. Whatever you do in the AND gate is similarly done in case of NAND gate also. But the answer is exactly opposite. See, 0 into 0 is 0, but if you come to NAND gate, you need to write the answer as 1. You need to invert the answer because we are using NOT gates here, right? So, this is all about the logic gates, our important Zener diode, forward bias. Please remember these all formulae, memorize them, practice them, okay? This is all about our semiconductor devices. Friends, hope you all understood my video. Do practice every day, prepare well for your exam. Vyans Medical Academy wishes you good luck for NEET 2019. Thank you.